So what is Taking Action Group? What's it all about? So that's what this video is about. The primary mission of this particular Taking Action Group is to promote activism and action. So it's right in the name, right? Taking action. Now, the thing is that there's a lot of people out there that see, you know, things that are going on and, you know, in our society, in our government, and they say, you know what, that's not right. I want to try to make a change, or maybe I have this cool idea that maybe we could, like, you know, visit, and how can we go about making these actual things a reality in our lives? And people don't know what to do, so they just sign a petition and then it just goes nowhere, and then they just say, hey, you know, I try to do something and nothing happens. We're here to change that. We're here to transform people that are frustrated with the current system into knowledgeable and actively participating activists that can affect change that is constantly subverted by those who have interest in maintaining the status quo. This isn't a normal type of organization. There is no formal membership. There's no dues, anything like that. Our meetings are just rather attended by activists that are looking for people to help them achieve real-world results. We are like an incubator for people who are developing organizers. We are also a hub for like a resource, not only just for manpower, but also for knowledge and resources as well. Also, by meeting with other activists, you could find out what was effective for them and then try it out yourself and see how that works for you. And super excited about this particular project. Now, a major key to our organization is the Tulsi Action Database, or the Taking Action Database. And it's actually a publicly viewable and editable document, and the link is right below. All right, let's actually go over it. I'm gonna go over it on the screen with you because understanding the sheet is actually really an important part of interacting with this organization.
All right, so the first thing right here we have is the Tulsi Action Group Database. And this is actually a very central document for, you know, pretty much everything we do. It's really, you know, the key to the whole program. So we could see that there's a bunch of sheets on the bottom here. We have our Zoom link. We have contacts list. We have a meeting agenda, topic requests, and lessons learned in the field. We have a link to our weekly organizing meeting here, right? And if this should change, then it will be updated on this sheet. This Tulsi Action Group Database is basically put in a lot of our links from our videos, from our newsletters. Like, everything really should be pushing people towards our Tulsi Action Group Database. I guess we'll change this to the Taking Action Group Database right now, okay? I am a big fan of Tulsi still, but, you know, she's not actually running in any races, and she's on her way out, you know, of the House of Representatives. Right now, we're back to the Taking Action Group. Besides the Zoom meetings, which you have every week where you can talk with us in person, we also have the Facebook group over here. Yeah, this is a private group, so you have to be vetted to a certain extent. We also have our tag event calendar over here, where we have this information where you can see what's coming up. So this calendar is available for you. The link will also be included in the description below. The last two sheets will be meeting agenda topic requests, and we also have lessons learned in the field. So now, let's talk about the way that these meetings are run and how they're organized. So the Taking Action Group meetings occur in three phases. Now, the three phases go like this. The first phase is the action phase. We always prioritize action over everything. So the thing is that in the beginning, everybody just kind of shows up in the meeting, and I'm moderating. Everybody shows up for the online Zoom meeting, and then I am moderating. Now, people, if they want to beforehand, they can. This meeting is open for editing by anybody. It's open source, so because it's, you know, available, the only real protection that we have for this particular document is to just constantly make backups and to save our own particular copies. So, you know, it's kind of like blockchain in that way. It's totally open source. Now, the thing is that someone will make a recommendation of a certain action. For example, destroy the DNC. Someone will present the issue, and that person was myself. They can put their email address down. Now, their email address, my contact information is on this sheet. So people just can just go to this sheet and then contact me. But if people are interested, they just sign up next to it, right? They just put their name next to the particular action that they're interested in supporting, and then we can just move forward from there. Now, there's going to be some differences of opinion. There are going to be some people who say, like, this is right, this is wrong. We don't have those discussions at this particular part of the phase. In phase one, someone suggest an action, and then people just put their support next to it. Obviously, if someone says, my action is that I want to go and kill people, then, you know, come on, man, it's ridiculous. Now, we're not going to put that on the board. But let's suppose someone says, you know, I want to support this third party or that third party. You know, I know one very influential member named James Rusguski has tried to form something called the Progressive Party. Then you have the existing Green Party or, you know, other third-party options or people who still want to go through the DNC, entering the Democratic Party and trying to take over from within. And I'm going to start a new series called Taking the Blue Pill, where I actually do actually go down that pathway. Every time that a new action is proposed, a new group will form to try to get these actions completed. So the thing is that each group has is allowed to have its own leadership style or technique or have its own management or ways of doing things. And if someone in the group doesn't agree with the way they're doing, they can create their own action, you know, round up their own people and, you know, do things separately. You know, it's not like we're going to have a war or there's like leaders. You know, if someone just has a different idea, you're welcome to try it. As time goes on, right, we will learn who are the more effective people, what are the more effective methodologies, and people would be allowed to make their own decisions, you know, regarding, you know, what particular groups they want to join or how they want to go about running their own operations. If we take a look at school, there's not really a lot of instruction on how to be an activist, so people are just horrible at it. It's really bad, and that's actually for phase two, right? So phase one, remember, we don't really have... You don't really get the opportunity to discuss, right? I think that's right. I think that's wrong. I want it done another way, right? What, someone just proposes an idea, and other people can sign up. And then people can leave the meeting. They can stay in the meeting. There's no forcing anybody to stay. And once again, just remember that, you know, each group is free to carry out their mission as they see fit, using whatever methods they see fit. They are not under us. They are not, you know, we're just a meeting place for activists to get together. So we have no official position. We have no official leadership, and we are not really easy to take down. So that's the reality of what the Taking Action Group is. We prioritize action, not, you know, I have a title and, you know, you have to follow me. That's all out the window. Now, the second part of the phase is what we've learned. As we go through our activist experience, we may learn certain things. Like when I went through the Tulsi campaign, I saw a lot of cool, exciting things, such as like they decided to go on using signs to try to promote Tulsi in New Hampshire. And I was in New Hampshire, and I saw a lot of positive work being done. I thought to myself, you know, this should be successful. But then when I looked at the numbers at the end, it was horrible. So what I got from that is that it's not enough to just hand out signs. It's not enough to just hand out flyers. We have to actually develop relationships with people. We have to get to know them so they will actually, you know, come out and vote for, you know, in the way that we need them to. We have to prove ourselves because there's so much disengagement from the political process. So that's the second phase. Now in the second phase, a little bit more discussion is allowed. And then in the last phase, the very third phase, it's basically just people can present whatever they want. It's just open, you know, people can get to know each other, they can hang out, they can do whatever they want. So some people will have certain ideas that they really, really, really want the rest of the group to hear. They'll be like, oh, you know, I have this particular idea and everybody's got to hear it. Well, you're going to have to wait till the end. You know, if some people don't want to stay to listen to it, that's too bad. But, you know, I will provide an opportunity for you to speak and to be heard. But, you know, the people have to be willing to, and you're not allowed to hijack action, right, things that are actively going on in order to promote your particular idea. You will have a chance, but that will happen at the very end. Because everybody has ideas, right? But the ideas are only good if they actually net a benefit. So that's the way this organization is run. We prioritize that. That's really all there is to it. That's the only really enforcement that I really do. Making sure that things go smoothly on that end. Making sure that things get done. Yeah? So the second phase, once again, is what we've learned. And the third phase is kind of like an open, you know, you know, some people just go to these things because they want to get to know another person. Or they want to sit and listen to other ideas. And you know, that's available here too. So look, this is super critical that we make action happen. That's the hook of this particular channel too, right? There's a lot of YouTubes out there that are, you know, having shows that inform you, tell you what's going on, right? And then you have to take the action on yourself. You got to figure out how to organize on your own. This is an organizing channel. This is me and Lisa, we're going to make some videos that, you know, teach people how to be organizers. There's a real lack of this particular information out there. So we're going to put it out. Contact me if you're an activist as well and you want to share some of your ideas on this channel. We're very eager to hear from you. Thank you so much and have a beautiful day. These videos are independently produced and funded, and your support is deeply appreciated. Liking the video and subscribing helps the channel, and ringing the bell icon will keep you notified as to when we upload new content. You can also check out our other social media platforms. We'd love to hear from you. We also have our event calendar. Links in the description. On our Reddit, you can come in and get on the conversation and check out some of the memes. Like and share, it really helps us in the YouTube algorithm. Every week on Sunday, we have a live online meeting where you can join us in working to create and nurture the change that we need. I'd like to invite you to check out some of our other videos. Until next time, may all your actions bring you success. Stay focused, stay strong, and reinvest in yourself as well as your community. Together, our efforts can be greater than the sum of the parts. The power is in your hands. Thanks for watching.